Before we start our story, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe and don't forget to like the video so that you're always updated on my new uploaded videos. Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay, the first explorers to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Edmund Hillary of New Zealand and Tenzing Norgay of Nepal became the first explorers to reach the summit of Mount Everest, the world's highest mountain at 29,035 feet above sea level, on May 29, 1953, at 11:30 a.m. The two, who were part of a British expedition, launched their final assault on the summit after a restless night at 27,900 feet. Mount Everest is located on the Nepal-Tibet border, on the Asian crest of the Great Himalayas. The Tibetans call the mountain Chomo-Lungma, which translates to Mother Goddess of the Land, and the English named it after Sir George Everest, a British surveyor of South Asia in the 19th century. The peak of Everest is two-thirds of the way through the Earth's atmosphere, roughly the cruise altitude of commercial jetliners, when oxygen levels are extremely low, temperatures are extremely cold, and weather is unpredictable and dangerous. In 1921, a British crew set out on the first known attempt to climb Everest, hiking 400 miles across the Tibetan plains to the mountain's base. A violent storm forced them to abandon their climb, but the mountaineers, including George Lee Mallory, had discovered what appeared to be a potential route up the top. "Because it's there," Mallory told a journalist when asked why he wanted to climb Everest. In 1922, a second British expedition led by Mallory returned, with climbers George Finch and Jeffrey Bruce reaching a height of over 27,000 feet. Seven Sherpa porters were killed in an avalanche during Mallory's second attempt that year. Sherpas, who are native to the Khumbu region, have traditionally played an important supporting role in Himalayan climbs and treks due to their strength and ability to resist high elevations. Climber Edward Norton reached an elevation of 28,128 feet, 900 vertical feet short of the summit, without the aid of artificial oxygen, during a third British Everest expedition in 1924. 4 days later, Mallory and Andrew Irvine launched a summit attempt and were never seen alive again. Mallory's body was discovered nearly intact high on Everest in 1999, he had fractured several bones in a fall. It's uncertain whether he or Irvine ever reached the pinnacle of success. Several more failed summit attempts were made along Tibet's northeast ridge path, and after World War II, Tibet was closed to foreigners. In 1949, Nepal opened its doors to the outside world, and in 1950 and 1951, British teams climbed the southeast ridge route. In 1952, a Swiss expedition made the first serious summit attempt, climbing the treacherous Khumbu icefall. Due to a lack of supplies, Raymond Lambert and Tenzing Norgay were forced to return to 28,210 feet, just below the south summit. Following the Swiss expedition's near success, a big British expedition led by Colonel John Hunt was scheduled for 1953. The mission gathered talent from the British Commonwealth, in addition to the top British climbers and such highly experienced Sherpas as Tenzing Norgay. For example, New Zealanders George Lowe and Edmund Hillary worked as beekeepers while they weren't climbing mountains. Insulated boots and gear, as well as portable radios and open and closed circuit oxygen systems, were provided for the voyage. In April and May 1953, the expedition made its way up the mountain, building up a series of camps along the route. Climbers carved a new passage through the Khumbu icefall, ascending the western CWM, crossing the Lhotse face, and arriving at the south COL at a height of about 26,000 feet. Charles Evans and Tom Bourdillon made the first climb of Everest on May 26, coming within 300 feet of the summit before having to turn back due to a failed oxygen set. On May 28, Tenzing and Hillary headed out for high camp at 27,900 feet. After a chilly, sleepless night, the two pushed on, reaching the south summit at 9 a.m. and a steep, 40-foot-high rocky step an hour later. By squeezing himself into a crevice in the face, Hillary ascended what became known as the Hillary Step. After Hillary tossed down a rope, Norgay followed her. Around 11:30 a.m., the climbers reached the top of the world. The news of the expedition's success was delivered by runner from the base camp to the Namshbazar radio station, which was subsequently relayed to London via coded message on June 1, the day before Queen Elizabeth II's coronation. The next day, the news reached every corner of the globe. Later that year, the Queen knighted Hillary and Hunt. Norgay was only given the British Empire Medal because he was not a Commonwealth citizen. Since Hillary and Norgay's historic journey, numerous teams have attempted to reach Everest's summit. In 1960, a Chinese crew became the first to climb Everest from the Tibetan side, and in 1963, James Whittaker became the first American to do it. In 1975, Tobei Junko of Japan became the first woman to reach the summit. 3 years later, Reinhold Messner of Italy and Peter Habeler of Austria achieved the hitherto unthinkable, climbing to the summit of Everest without oxygen. Over 300 climbers have died while attempting to ascend the mountain. On April 25, 2015, 19 individuals were killed in an avalanche at Everest Base Camp after a 7.8 earthquake devastated Nepal, killing over 9,000 people and injuring over 23,000 more. Eight climbers perished in a blizzard high on the slopes in 1996, an incident memorialized in John Krakauer's book Into Thin Air. The amount of people ready to pay tens of thousands of dollars to climb the world's highest peak was unaffected by Krakauer's book. There have been reports of traffic jams near the summit, and in 2013, a fistfight erupted between three European climbers and more than 100 Sherpas over what the guides regarded to be impolite and reckless behavior during an attempted ascent. Meanwhile, the deaths continue, with over 10 so far this year. Mount Everest, 7 things you should know. 1. Until the 19th century, no one realized Everest was the world's roof. The Great Trigonometrical Survey was launched by the British in 1802, with the intention of mapping the Indian subcontinent. Heavy machinery, rough terrain, monsoons, malaria, and scorpions made the work much more difficult. Despite this, the surveyors were able to gather exceptionally accurate data. The Himalayas, not the Andes, were swiftly established as the world's highest mountain range. Everest, then known as Peak 15, was named the king of them all in 1852, and its elevation was measured at 29,002 feet above sea level in 1856. According to modern GPS technology, they were only 27 feet away, or 33 feet, depending which survey you reference. 2. Tenzing and Hillary may have been beaten to the summit. From 1921 to 1924, George Mallory, a British schoolteacher, took part in the first three known efforts to climb Mount Everest. "It is nearly unthinkable," he wrote before the last of those missions. "I don't think I'll make it to the top, I don't see myself going down beaten." On June 4, 1924, a teammate reached as close to the summit as 900 vertical feet before turning back. Mallory and her climbing partner Andrew Irvine then set off on their own quest for glory. They left Camp 6 on June 8 at 26,800 feet and were last seen slogging upwards in their tweed coats, hobnailed boots, and other basic clothes that afternoon. Some claim Mallory and Irvine made it to the top before succumbing on the way down. A camera they were rumored to be carrying could help solve the mystery, but it was not found in Mallory's pockets when his body was discovered in 1999. Irvine's body has yet to be discovered. 3. Tenzing had previously come close to reaching the summit. The next 10 or so missions to Mount Everest after Mallory's death were all fruitless. Tenzing Norgay gained valuable experience by participating in 6 of them, initially as a porter and subsequently as a full member of the team. He and a Swiss climber came within 800 vertical feet of the top in 1952, perhaps the highest point in the planet. Since then, almost 4,000 more climbers have attempted Everest, including Hillary's son and one of Tenzing's children. 4. When a climber passes away en route, their bodies are frequently left behind. Over 300 people have died trying to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Avalanches, rock slides, blizzards, falls, altitude sickness, freezing temperatures, exhaustion, and combinations of these have all claimed lives, particularly above 26,000 feet in the death zone. The majority of the dead remain up there since taking them down is difficult and dangerous. They are beautifully preserved in the snow and appear to be used as trail markers by passing climbers. In May 1996, 8 people died in a storm, a tragedy memorialized in John Krakauer's book Into Thin Air. Regardless, Krakauer's book had little effect on people paying tens of thousands of dollars to climb the world's tallest peak. 5. The litter problem on Everest extends far beyond cadavers. Parts of Mount Everest had become the highest junkyard on the face of the earth, according to a climber who wrote in National Geographic in 1963. Empty oxygen bottles, human waste, food packaging, damaged climbing equipment, and shredded tents continue to pollute the ecosystem. Over 8 tons of rubbish were taken from Everest during a single cleanup in spring 2011, and many more tons remain uncollected. To solve the problem, the Nepalese government now requires climbers to return with all of their belongings or face losing their deposit money. New trash cans and a waste incinerator have recently been constructed near the mountain. 6. Only a few creatures travel to the summit of Everest. At lower elevations, Sagarmatha National Park, which encompasses Mount Everest and neighboring peaks, supports a diverse range of species, including snow leopards, musk deer, red pandas, and Himalayan tar. The park is also home to about 150 different bird species. Above 20,000 feet, however, almost no fauna can be found because persistent snow prohibits even the hardiest lichens and mosses from growing. Yellow-billed chuffs, a crow-like bird that has followed mountaineers up to around 26,500 feet, and barheaded geese, which migrate from the Tibetan plateau to India's wetlands, are among the outliers. 7. From sea level, Everest is the highest point, but other mountains are taller. Mauna Kea is a volcano on Hawaii's Big Island that rises 13,796 feet above sea level. Because it rises from the seabed, it has a base to summit height of more than 33,000 feet, making it the world's tallest mountain by that metric. Everest isn't even the closest thing to space. Because the Earth isn't a perfect spherical and bulges in the middle, Ecuador's 20,561-foot Mount Chimborazo takes the title.